Dominique, and I'm rocking out with Chi-Town.
Chi-Town
Urban Radio.
Good, it's your girl KT
Lace.
I'm rocking with DJ Malone.
Chi-Town
Urban Radio.
Hey guys, this is the Chilla, ATTXLA, because X marks the spot all day, every day. And you are watching or listening to, depending on what you're doing, Chi-Town Urban Radio. Thank you.
You jam into Chi-Town Urban Radio.
This is your AK, and I'm rocking with Chi-Town Urban Radio. What's up?
Hey man, now we'll just now we done it again, Monsi. We done it again. So you're streaming live on just, you know, Facebook Live and stuff like that.
Yeah.
I tell people this all the time. They should have never gave black people live. Never. But we in the mix, man. Right here. If you want to call in and speak to her, 312-985-7834, man, is the number to call in and you know, talk to AK, man. See, you a cool people, man. You cool. I like you, man. So, now as far as your production, who would you like to work with as producer-wise?
Producer-wise, I mean, I'm pretty much open.
Okay.
I don't necessarily have a favorite right now.
Not what about Metro Boomin?
Metro Boomin. I mean, well, you know what? Actually, let me not say that.
Okay.
I do have a favorite. DJ L is definitely, like,
okay.
He's definitely super sick on it, you know. And hearing C Sick, Metro is definitely cool, you okay. know. I just didn't want to put so much. You know how the people have their favorites and you don't want to feel too special, but yeah, definitely L, for real.
Okay, definitely,
you
man.
Know, London on the track.
Yeah.
He's super neat too.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Hey man, I really enjoy your flow, you know what I'm saying? What do you think about the Drizzies and the Tinks, like the other girls, you know, the Katie got bands, you know, what's your thoughts on the Chicago female rap game right now?
I feel like the female rap game is being taken out of its place with certain things, and it's actually holding it, someone is definitely holding it. I think a lot of female rappers is kind of scared to bite at it, you know, and I'm not one of them.
Yeah, hey, I like that. Monty, you hear what she says? I'm not one of them. That's what I'm talking about, man. Let's talk about Dip. Let's talk about this, man, because we're about to break it right now. Yeah. Tell us about Dip, man.
Man, Dip was actually stating the brand, you feel me, like Sassy Gang.
Yeah.
Man, it's definitely from where I come from. You know, like, I'm not going back to where I come from. I'm going forward. Ever since I started getting extensions and getting my nails and stuff done, I never went back to regular.
Mm.
I keep my no chip and I keep my gel. I don't go back to acrylic.
Definitely.
Because I've been moving forward. You know what I'm saying? So basically, like, I'm moving forward. I ain't going back. I'm gonna keep getting this money and I'm gonna keep doing what I gotta do for my fans.
Real.
And I'm gonna keep it real. Like, this is what I love to do. I wouldn't be doing it if it wasn't
real.
You feel me?
That's what it is. You got a video for it yet?
I definitely do have a video for
it. We gotta check it out, man.
You can check that out on YouTube.
Okay.
It's actually on my artist page as well. All
right.
And I'm pretty sure, like, when a Vivo come up, it got pushed back.
Okay.
Yeah. So it should definitely be on Vivo.
Okay, definitely, man. Let's get into it right now. It's called Dip, man. You want to introduce the track, AK?
Yo, go check out that Dip, AK.
Let go.
This Chicago.
Who is this? Stick, she is a stick, shit. Flip you like a switch, girl. I
make it slip. But the hate, yeah, I got the dub, dub. I've been had to trip, trip. I got so much stuff, I make it slip. Got that hat, look at my shoes, look at my racks, cause I gain shit. I ain't going back now, look at my shoes, look at my racks, cause I gain shit. I ain't going back now, look at my shoes, look at my racks, cause I gain shit. You ain't going back, gotta run it back, like I'm gonna run it back. If you talking shit, I'ma hit it with a bat. I'm on, I don't wanna hear it, I don't wanna hear it, no. I got the trip, trip, bitch, I got the trip. I got so much stuff, so much stuff that make it slip. What the hell, yeah, I got the dub, dub. I've been had to trip, trip. I got so much stuff that make it slip. Look at my shoes, look at my racks, cause I gain shit. I ain't going back now, look at my shoes, look at my racks, cause I gain shit. I ain't going back now, look at my shoes, look at my racks, cause I gain shit. I ain't going back now, gotta run it back, rather run it back. If you talking shit, I'ma hit it with a back. I'm on.
Performing that, G. I want to see that.
I'm real live when I'm performing. I'm just another person up there.
Hey, I see that, man, because I can tell just from the cadence on the track. Yo, like, you came on there like, hey, I'm here. Let's get it. Let's go, man.
Let's go. Let's kick up.
Definitely, man. Definitely. Yeah. So, when you go into the studio, do you have any must-haves? Like, you know, I know whenever I DJ, I got to have, like, my pop. I got to have, like, a Reese's or something.
Yeah.
Do you have a must-have for whenever you're in the studio to get that feeling going?
I mean, I definitely have to have some warm water.
Yeah.
Good vibes.
Definitely.
And God.
That's what it is.
I don't really do too much anything else.
Definitely. So you was, and you said you song, you do your songwriting and everything.
Yeah, I do. Yeah.
Let's talk about that. Now, how do you go into that place? Because I know a lot of songwriters, they have to be some in a dark room. Some, you know, they just have to feel that energy coming about. How do you go about writing a song?
I mean, my methods is crazy. Monty himself said, you need to pick one because it's really all over the place. I mean, yeah. The thing is, it's like, I'm just a very creative person, and anything and everything I do, I always turn it into something else that, you know, that people probably wouldn't think it could be.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, I write, freestyle it first, spit it, bring it back, come back to it, write down something, you know, record it while I'm rapping it, and that might be the song right there.
Real, real.
I mean, to be honest, that's how Dip was made. I heard the beat. I'm like, this is sick.
Yeah, yeah.
And I just bob. I've been had to dip. Hey. I got the trip.
Yeah.
And then that was just that was it.
Hey, you see how her cadence is, man, when she comes on beats? I
no,
like
that. I'm already knowing what it is, which is why, you know, I'm really, you know, I'm really proud to be working with her. She is she's definitely unique. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, I'm trying to be as strategic and as clever as possible as far as assisting her music career.
Real, real.
You know, we were actually having a conversation yesterday because I got a chance to meet one of her producers. Very cool guy. You know, I got some, you know, advice from a lot of music talent, you know, that have actually been where she's trying to go, you know, as hold far on. As directions to hold take on, for
hold
her.
On, hold on, take. We got a caller on the line. Let's get the caller. Uh-huh. Man, caller, man, you're on the line, man. Take your name where you're calling from.
Yo, it's your big homie Young Shattown, man. What's happening?
What's going on? How you feeling, man?
I'm cool, man. What's the word, Seth?
Man, you on the line with me and DJ Malone and AK, man. AK's in the building, man. He's our guest for today.
Oh, salute, man. What's happening, AK?
What's up? How you feeling?
Anything you want?
Man, I'm crazy.
Anything you want to ask her or you know, talk to her?
Oh, I can ask questions? Now, you know I'm crazy.
Oh, my God. You know, well, go ahead. Ask your question, man.
I had to get it on my third, okay?
That's good.
AK.
What's up?
What do you rather like, sneakers or M&M's?
M&M's.
Oh, wait. Okay.
But the real question is, what kind of M&M's? You like the peanut butters?
I just like the peanuts with the nuts in them.
Oh, you like with the nuts in them? With the nuts in them.
You know what? Shut down.
I'm done with
you. You ain't no good, man. You ain't no good.
I'm done with you.
But she kind of set us up.
Great.
All BS aside, man. Hey, salute, man, to the family, man. Monty, what's up, bro?
What's going on, bro?
DJ Malone, man, of course.
Shut up, bro.
AK, man. You know, you're definitely doing a great job. So keep up the good work, man. You already know what it is, man. Shout out to the radio, man. And we got some special on the way, too. You understand that?
Definitely. Yeah. All right, man. I appreciate you calling in, man. Showing support.
Yes, sir, bro. You already know.
Definitely, man. All right, bro.
Yeah.
Definitely. Now, let me ask you this, AK. Let me ask you this. I ain't gonna ask you nothing crazy.
Right.
Whenever you see, you know, your fans or whatever, and you see the reaction with your fans, and they kind of, you know, they big you up, how does that make you feel?
When they big me up.
Yeah, like, you know, like, yeah, that's my girl, like, yeah. I hype you up, and...
I mean, those are definitely friends that I want to keep around.
Real,
and
real.
That just makes me feel more like, just more great about what I'm doing. The
real,
fact
real.
That it's coming from my friends. You know what I'm saying? Like, I mean, I had a friend like, gee, I want to put your song on the radio, bro. Like, you don't even understand. I was just like, thank you that
real,
you
real.
Feel like that. You feel what I'm saying? Like, it really means a lot to me.
It
means more than anything to me because, like, the support... A lot of people lack support, and at first I was lacking a lot of that. I felt like I had to prove myself, and then a lot of people like, you know what, you really about this. You're not doing this just because you're cute and you just want to do this or whatever. This is what you really want to do.
Real.
And I started getting a lot of feedback, and I getting a lot of positive energy about it, you know, from my friends especially.
Okay.
And I really appreciate that.
That's real. I know off air we talked about the, you know, the EP or the mixtape that you got going on.
Yeah.
Is there any word on that, the date or, you know, anything going on with that yet?
As far as, you know, the album and the mixtape, it's not set in stone.
Okay.
It's not set in stone like the date, but I have my date.
I have
a date. Oh, yo,
I always tell people there's always three dates. There's the artist date, the label date, and the actual date the distribution has. So, you know, there's always dates going on. So
yeah.
We'll still be in touch. I'll be looking in tune. So whenever you got that, you know, album coming, come back up here.
For sure.
And you know what we're gonna do, Monty. We'll do a listening party right here on Shytown Urban Radio.
Okay.
I'll hit up some of all my DJ friends up, tell them to tune in, and we'll have an online listening party.
Dope.
That, people not doing that nowadays, man. So
yeah.
Definitely, man. Let me ask you this. Now, as far as, you know, getting your stuff prepared, what is the single that you're pushing? I know you got the same thing in the dip. So those are the two joints that you really... pushing hard and getting it to go and stuff like that?
They're getting the best response.
Okay.
And you know, like those are the two that I felt that would get people to be like, you know what? Yeah, she dope. Like she got, you know, feel what I'm saying? Like she got swag and she's saying something. No, it's more than just making a party song. Like I actually want to say something.
Yeah.
I'm actually saying something. Even if it's just cooling in my zone and I got it going on.
Yeah.
That itself is a statement itself of what's going on.
Definitely.
But yeah, like, I definitely plan on making more than that.
I'm interested to see, man. Monty, man. Anything you want to say to her, you know, as your people, so.
Definitely, you know, in the end of the day, it's all about staying focused. It's about knowing your deadlines, knowing your goal, you know. Never forget the goal. As long as you remember the goal, you know, every day that you wake up, you'll always work towards that goal. Things will always be accomplished. So, like I said, we just started working about a week ago. You know, I'm putting all my chips in a bag on this one, because I definitely believe in her talent.
Real.
I definitely believe in her drive, you know, and you know, we'll see where it goes from there. But you know, like I tell her all the time, I don't run no races that I can't win. So
real.
You know, ain't nothing but to do it. You know what I'm saying? So
real.
Let's go.
And that's what it is, man. Let's get back into the music real quick. When I come right back, man, we got a couple questions, man. We're going to get to know AK, man. So the one and only DJ Malone, Monty the Motive, AK is in the building, man. Let's go ahead and get into some mixes real quick. Let's go.
This is Chicago.
This party. Hey Malone, bring that track in.
Sunshine, we touch my game, we gon' turn this to Columbine. Ice on my neck, cost me 10 times 3. $30,000 for a nigga to get free. I just hit Rodeo and I spent like 10 G's. I just did a show and spent the check on.
Chi-Town over radio, the best place to be at any day, really. Man, we still got my girl into the building, AK. What's going on, man?
What's
how
up,
you feeling?
What's up?
Hey man, so I told you we're gonna come back and ask you a couple questions.
Yeah.
So, what is your favorite? And I mean favorite. I'm gonna do this. Give me your top 3 albums of all time. Top 3.
Really?
Good question.
Top 3 albums of all time. I'll say The Blueprint.
Okay.
I'm definitely, for some reason, I feel bad for not knowing that, but definitely Lauryn Hill's album.
Yeah.
And let me see, that third one.
That third one will catch you.
That third one, though. Okay. I don't know, I gotta sit on that one.
Okay, that's fine.
But... I mean, I listen to a lot of artists, so I'm gonna have to go with that. That new Jeezy that just dropped.
The new one,
yeah.
Hey, that go hard though, man.
Yeah. I was thinking about that in Gucci.
Okay.
But definitely my boy Gucci though. Like, I definitely rocking with that.
Definitely.
But that's
No Man
3.
Definitely.
That's hot.
I listened to it, and I think he's getting back to what we know him as, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I really enjoyed it. Because I got the album, I was like, let me check it out. Let me see what's going on here, man. So,
yeah.
Definitely. Okay. Let me ask you this. What's your favorite type of pop?
My favorite type of pop would be, like, the kind that you just, like, you can move to.
Okay.
But, like... believe it or not, like the little sentimental kind.
Okay.
You know, that dance pop, but then like you expressing your feelings at the same time. I mean, like, I'll say maybe dubstep.
Dubstep?
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
Definitely.
Because, I mean, they constantly, like, definitely, like, repeat the same thing over and over again.
Yeah.
Which we do when we go into stuff. We just keep going over and over and over again. And then until you get it out of your head,
yeah.
You dance to it, it's all the way. So, definitely that.
Are you, now, let me ask you this. Are you in a relationship? You got a significant other, boyfriend?
I am not currently dating.
Why is that? Because it's just because of the, of your business and stuff like that, or just
all of the above?
Okay, I could a lot of
cause people are crazy.
Well, I'm gonna be honest with you. I think a lot of people and with females, they can't handle a female who's pretty and who's in that type of light. You get what I'm saying?
Yeah, I agree with that. The don't get me wrong, like you know, women's independence is great and everything, but you know. The level of women independence now in 2016 is so high that it intimidates most men. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It makes a lot of quote unquote men, specifically speaking about the men who aren't that independent. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like people who just making it bad versus, you know, the men who got they stuff together, they ish together, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Okay.
I feel like, you know, the independent woman nowadays definitely intimidates most of the average men, you know what I'm saying?
Okay, yeah.
Yeah. Well, it's just not up my alley right now.
Real,
like, I'd rather keep my focus. If a person is more interested than, like, trying to feel me out than trying to see where I'm trying to go so we can build something together, then it's not really the right role for us.
Real.
You know, it could be a big distraction. And I'm a woman. Any woman, I feel like I love hard.
Real.
And I love forever.
We got a caller.
Yeah, I will never let you go.
Caller, man, state your name, where you're calling from.
It's your girl Nisha. How may I help you?
You called me.
Right.
Who? Hello?
Pastor, you told me to call you. Yes, I did call you.
No, I didn't tell you to call. I said I was on air and you called here.
Pull up the messages. Pull up the messages.
Anyways, we got AKs in the building. What's going on?
Hey,
how y'all
doing today? Hey,
what's up, lady? Country,
then? Oh, God. She is tired.
Where you? She's from Texas, so she gonna have that country aspect. Anything you wanna ask, AK, man?
No, not today. I'm sorry. I've been misinformed. You know, I and I'm on my way to work. You just upset my spirit, you know. No, I'm just playing. What made y'all stop in today? What are y'all discussing?
I mean, really, you know, we're just talking to AK. But let me ask you this, because Monty just brought up a good situation. Do you feel like guys are more intimidated of women being more independent now?
Very much so. If, you know, a woman flaunts it in your face all the time, oh, you know, it's nice to have you, but I don't need you. Why am I here? Let me do the, you know, as a man, if I was a man, I would feel like, you know, let me do those things. Let me protect you. So,
yeah.
Now you have men that really aren't men. They're still boys. And I'm not talking about trivial stuff and such as, oh, every door you have to open and stuff like that. But there's been times I've seen, you know, women down there pumping gas, changing tires, all of it.
But
I feel like that's unacceptable.
Well, so let me ask you this. Do you think it's more fair for a man to do it, to change your tires and everything?
Some things, yes. I'm old school. I still feel like men should take out trash, men should change tires.
Okay.
If they're present.
Now,
if you don't have a man, then you don't just let that trash pile up. That's trifling.
Yeah. AK, what's your thoughts on that, man?
I mean,
I like her. That
as a woman, I mean, I feel like we should definitely hold it down. But if there's a man around and he's laying up, I mean, there's no need for you to be going out asking for somebody for some food when he's been over your house all these type of days and they cooked or bought you nothing and took the trash out. I mean, you they that disgusting.
You bogus.
So you got to get rid of him.
Yeah, definitely. Well, hey, that's what it is then. So you going to take out my trash?
Not at all. Never.
Oh, yeah, you is. Yeah, you is. You going to change my tires and you going to cook for me. You going to do everything.
You're right. You're right about one thing. I will cook for you. I will cook, but that's because I enjoy cooking. And that's because I want to poison you. Okay?
I got you on air. I got you. What time is it, Monty? What time?
It's
1:31. Yeah, 1:31 on Wednesday, November, what is it, 16th? And I will be showing the cops this. I will.
You can tell them. Please tell them.
I was threatening.
I want you to take out Trump, too.
Okay. Definitely, man. Hey, I appreciate you calling in. We got to get this other caller.
No problem. Y'all have a great one.
All right. Too.
Man, caller, man. State your name, where you're calling from. You're on the line with DJ Malone and AK.
No poop, but I've been watching her for a while now, and she's just so awesome.
Thank you.
Anything you want to ask her, or you know, tell her
just,
or whatever.
Just keep up the good work. Just stay positive. Don't let nothing get in your way. You got it, girl.
Thanks, Ma. I appreciate it.
That's what it is. Thank you for calling in, baby.
Okay, thank you.
Chi-Town Urban Radio, man. Hey, how does that make you feel when people just call in and really show support?
Love. I mean, it touches me. I feel real good about that.
That's what's up.
I feel good about that because it's a lot. I mean, not to shoot anybody down or not to just, you know, be too arrogant about stuff. A lot of people, they're good at stuff like this, and they don't come up from it. You know what I'm saying? They'd be stuck in the same position. I mean, I'm not saying that I done made it out the hood or whatever the case is, but like the fact that it's getting recognized, and I know that I'm good at what I'm definitely great at what I do. And like she said, just keep a positive mind and just be positive about things. I'm just knowing, like, I get it everywhere. Like, you good, man.
Yeah,
it's not about being good. It's not about my looks. It's something else that's going to get me there.
Real.
Definitely, I have to be business founded.
Yeah, real.
For real. I got to take care of my business. So, like, it definitely touches me.
We're going to talk about that, man, when we come back, man. The business of this this music game. Because it's dirty. It's a dirty game.
Oh, yeah.
So, definitely, man. Hey, man, Chi-Town Urban Radio. We're going to come right back into the mix. Now, I told you guys yesterday I didn't do a theme mix. Now, usually when I do these theme mixes, I go back. Like, a couple weeks ago, I did an all 90s theme mix. 2 weeks ago, I did all 2000s of Chris Brown. Well, today, we're dedicating it to the old school Chicago rappers. I'm talking about Do or Die. I'm talking about Crucial Conflict, Twista. A lot of them people that people forgotten, but who kind of paved the way for Chicago rappers. So I just want to say a tribute. Big shout out to Johnny P. He's not dead. Mm-hmm. A lot of people think that he's dead. No, he's on life support. So, you know, just, you know, pray for him. Yeah. Keep your spirits up, man. Johnny P, this one's for you. Let's get into the mix real quick. The one and only DJ Malone, let go.
This is Chicago. Chicago.
The one and only DJ Malone, man. We still got my girl into the building, AK. What's going on, man?
Yeah.
Hey. Hey, I like this beat.
That.
Hey, I like that beat, man. So we're here, man. We just been, you know, chilling, talking. Let me ask you this real quick, man.
What's
now, this mannequin challenge, all these challenges. Are you doing the mannequin challenge?
I have not done the mannequin challenge. But when the Sokong challenge came out, you know, my manager was like, "Oh, yo, do it."
Yeah.
So I mean, we might just go ahead and do that.
Are you hip to that though? Like whenever the challenges come up or whatever popping trend is going on, are you hip to that?
It's not one of my things that I'm into, but like, I mean, I it's cool.
Yeah.
I'm interested in it, but it's not nothing like I would be, let me do that.
Let me do that. I just got to be like everybody else in the world.
Yeah,
man.
Monkey see, monkey do crap.
Monty, are you doing a mannequin challenge, Monty?
I've done one already.
Yeah.
You done one already?
Yeah. I shot a video.
Talking to the microphone.
I shot a video about 3 days ago. in Indianapolis, Indiana. After we got done shooting the video, you know, we chilled or whatever, went out to eat, you know what I'm saying, just hung out, you know, went to a couple stores or whatever.
Yeah.
And we linked up with a shoe store owner. He sells Jordans, and they also restore pre-owned Jordans.
Okay.
Also, it was an album signing happening at the shoe store as well, which was the main reason we were there. Yeah. So, you know, once that was all over with, you know, we was chopping it up with the owners, everybody, we was just kicking it. And we just had this idea to do the mannequin challenge. So,
okay.
You know, the artists who I was shooting for, myself, one of the other artists that I work, that I shoot for, G-Lo Pierre, he was out there, and a couple of the other guys, and we just all decided to do the mannequin challenge. It was dope. It turned out real cool.
Oh,
it turned out super
God.
Dope.
I've seen some really creative ones, like the ones in the gym and stuff.
Yeah, that
the
was
drive-by
dope.
Drive-by shooters and stuff. Oh, I'm like, yeah.
Yeah, people are getting written out. There's a new challenge.
Yeah, it's called...
In Your Face?
No, F It Up. F It Up. The F It Up Challenge.
Oh, my.
The F It Up Challenge.
Well, who's coming up with these
twerking
challenges, Monty?
I don't know, but... Shoot, where's the get money challenge? That's what I'm
Hey, where's the bank account challenge?
Right, yeah. That's what I'm waiting on.
Definitely, man. So let me ask you this. Now, as far as business-wise, man, I know you got to have a boss team behind you, man, because these cats.
Yeah.
They be on some foo-foo stuff. So you got a boss team behind you?
Oh, definitely so. Like, we like a pack of thieves, though.
Yeah.
I'm telling you, like, it's definitely Hollywood ENT, Sassy Yang.
Okay.
He definitely up in it. Monty, he came in, you feel me? He didn't know what he was getting himself into. And
yeah.
He found out I was a monster.
Yeah, that's what it is.
She's scary.
How did you guys become, you know, the duo, man? How did you guys come together?
In a nutshell, we actually been following each other on social media for quite some time. But I didn't really know who she was, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I stumbled across her on Instagram, not even knowing that, you know, we were following each other on Instagram.
Yeah.
And I seen one of her shows.
Okay.
And I was like, man, she dope.
Yeah.
So, you know, me being me, I did some research, you know, I was checking out all her work, her SoundCloud, and I was like, man, like, she is really dope. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, she needs to be doing a lot more than what she's doing. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, she really has a product, and she has a great brand. And I felt like, you know, got her into the studio. We chopped it up. And, you know, I just felt like there were a lot of things that I could provide to assist her music career. You know what I'm saying? As far as, you know, her quality tracks. Her quality visuals, marketing, you know. But I've been doing packages like this. You know what I'm saying?
For years,
exactly. You know what I'm saying? And but when it comes to her, like, she's on a different level lyrically than most artists.
Yeah.
Her
wordplay crazy.
Okay, that's just a half of it though. Not only is she on a different level than most people, most artists, she's on a different level than all female artists. Like, I mean, the proof is in the music. You know what I'm saying?
It is.
And we working on some stuff right now that's definitely going to shock the world.
Real.
I mean, we are really planning on pushing the upcoming projects on a major label level.
Okay.
If you know what I mean.
Definitely. AK, when you met Monty, now he's kind of crazy. That's my guy, but he's crazy. what was it about him that, you know, kind of you guys wanted to work together or say, okay, you know what? Let's go ahead and do it. We're going to rock with each other.
He didn't talk as much. Yeah. I'm nervous when people talk so much to me about things and ain't show me anything.
Real.
Yeah, it gave me real nervous. He definitely gave me the demo, the background about everything, and that was very interesting that he could do that, you know. And then on top of that, set something up within a week for us to start doing stuff, you know. And the fact that I was able to bring my producer in, like one of my favorite producers in, and like they was able to vibe or whatever, and I got good feedback from it, that's kind of sold it for me too. His personality is very cool too, and a lot of guys can't vibe with me, but I have a lot of brothers. Yeah. You know, so like I know personally that I can vibe with a man, me being a woman.
Yeah.
But some guys, you know, and I just see like it's a different type of maturity here level. We on business.
Yeah, that's what it is. And that's why I guess I like him. I guess he's just okay.
Yes,
but you my guy, man. You my guy. But you know he's always been upfront with me.
Yeah.
I'm all about a guy. I'm very upfront. I'm not going to tell you nothing if I know I can't make it happen.
True.
That's just how I am, because it doesn't do no good for anybody else. You know, so I always tell people in this game, when you meet people who are really about something,
right,
hold on to them.
Mm-hmm.
Because there'll be a lot of cats who say, oh, well, I'm popping, I'm this, I'm that. Well, the DJ doesn't know you. I don't know you. And I'm pretty in the circle. So if they don't know you or anybody else know you, how popping is you? You know what I'm saying? So I want to come to you. You got any performances that you got going on, man? I want to come out to support, man.
That's coming up. I know we probably doing something for Thanksgiving.
Okay.
Yeah, but right now, like, pretty much, I'm working. I'm busy.
Yeah.
Anything upcoming, it's always a call away or inbox. And a lot of shows that I've been doing this year, like, they've coming up within like maybe a week in advance or whatever.
Yeah.
You know, it's been like, yo, you ready to do this? Ooh. Like, no disrespect to my craft, you know, anybody trying to rush me in, but
yeah,
a week is pretty, that's decent enough, especially in my Chicagoland or whatnot.
Yeah, yeah.
Anything planned, we probably plan like a month or two ahead, stuff that.
You got to.
I've done a lot of shows this year, so right now I'm definitely focusing on, you know, getting my craft out.
Yeah, okay.
Getting some more craft out.
Are you going to, are you doing any music festivals coming up, like, you know, South by Southwest? You should go.
I should go.
That I've seen a lot of artists get broke off of South by Southwest. It's in Austin, Texas. It's usually in March. I'll get you the information, because I usually do something around that time. Like, you know,
It's about March, April. They do it every year. It's a really big event. A lot of artists go, really for the sole purpose of networking. I think it's probably one of the best events, annual events for independent artists, to, you know, do some networking, you know, and have fun at the same time, you know, because it really is a big party, but it's, you know, it's a weekend solely for artists.
Real.
You know, and I mean, I have a lot of friends that have gone over the past 3-4 years. I myself have never been. But I'm thinking about going this year. I'm thinking about going, especially since one of my places of living will be closer.
Okay.
You know, I'll be living in Atlanta around that time, as well as Chicago. So I definitely think I'm gonna check it out this year.
Real.
Because yeah, like I said, I mean, a lot of people go, and the thing that I like about it is, you know, any artist that spends money on their craft, those are the people who I really want to work with. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
And anybody that's at that event, they pay money to be there. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, I mean, those are the people who you want to network with anyway.
Okay, definitely. You know? We're coming down to the nitty gritty of the interview, people. I told you guys, we got AKs in the building. Notice how I say you want to get to know this girl. You want to follow her, you want to check out. She got those songs, and I really am interested to see. I got to go back. I know you got some earlier stuff, so I got to go back and tune in to you, man. Just in case, tell everybody who's listening, tuning in, where can they find you if they want to check you out, or bookings or anything else like that?
You can definitely find out more about me and hear more at The Real AK, and that's spelled TheRealAK.
Definitely, man, definitely. Yes. Are you open to features?
I'm open to features.
Okay.
I am.
Okay, definitely.
I am open to features. I actually I'll get a lot of those, but I'm looking for, you know, some serious people.
Hey, that's what it is.
I think a lot of people just be trying to get close to me.
Hey, that might be. They're real tough.
I'm looking for some serious features, though.
Hey, but that's real, because you, I tell people this all the time. Sometimes it has to make sense.
It does.
And the thing is that people don't understand. Oh, well, yeah, I'm trying to get popping. I'm trying to get on.
Right.
But what is the reason for it?
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, whenever I DJ, I'm very careful on wherever I book or wherever I DJ at, because it has to make sense to me. Because if it's just some hood party or, you know, somebody ain't really nobody going to be there,
right.
It's not benefit towards you. Especially if you paying me to come out, right. It got to be some benefit towards you. Mm-hmm. So, you know, that's just what it is, man. Hey, Monty the Motor, give it everything where they can find you, bro.
Y'all can find me on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, Periscope.
You got Black Planet?
Google. Not Black Planet.
Yeah.
Hey, does that even still exist?
I know you got a MySpace.
No, I don't have one of those either. No MySpace.
What about a tag?
No, I don't have a tag.
You got a Craigslist ad?
You taking all of it. That's like you going way back since the beginning of social media.
You got a back page?
Hell no. Nah. Why would I have a back page?
I don't know. Some people have a back page.
Nah, I don't have one of those pages.
What about, what's that that old school? You got AIM. Instant Messenger. You got mail.
No, I don't have AIM. But yeah, you can follow me on social media, on, you know, anywhere at Monty the Motive. That's MONTYTHEMOTIVE. Anywhere. Or you can check me out at themotivestudio.com or the Motive Music Group. I'm sorry, motivemusicgroup.org.
Definitely.
Yeah.
All right, cool. And for all the people who's listening, because I am going to be broadcasting this in Houston on Saturday, so we're going to broadcast the interview yet again. Everybody who's just tuning in, man, in Houston, hey, man, make sure you guys get at her, talk to her. The real AK is in the building. Me, DJ Malone, next time you hear from me, we're going to be in Houston, Texas on Saturday, 11:30 p.m. to 1:30 a.m. at the Core 94. Now, I personally won't be there in person, but you can tune in and listen to it and support and do whatever you do. I'm hungry, so I'm about to get the hell up out of here. So, anyways, until next time, the one and only DJ Malone, Chi-Town Urban Radio. Follow us at chitownurbanradio.com. Oh, yeah, and make sure on Saturday, if you guys are not busy, November the 19th from 6:30 to 9:30, the Free for All event is happening. You get one free radio play and a free 5-minute interview. You come up there. It's at the Motive Studios. Give it the address, Monty.
The Motive Studio is located 1334 North Costner.
North Costner. That's out west. Well, northwest. Well, west. I guess west north, if you wish, I have to say.
It's west something like that.
Yeah.
West something.
Yeah, by the Cook Brothers.
Yeah, by the Cook Brothers.
Yeah, and if you don't know what that is, then I guess you're not really from the west side. It's the one and only DJ Malone. Until next time, we out. Why? Okay, cool.